Okay, hi everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video is a figure review on the NECA Ultimate Freddy vs. Jason Voorhees figure. I know I just did a Jason review on the 2009 Ultimate Jason figure, but this is the Ultimate Freddy vs. Jason Jason figure, and I'm so excited. This was just given to me as a gift from someone, and I'm only one Jason behind. I never got part 6, so I gotta get part 6 next, and then I think I will be caught up. The only Jasons I won't have are the video game ones, but maybe I'll get those down the road. But yeah, I'm very excited to have this guy. I do have the original NECA Jason from Freddy vs. Jason, which we will compare to in a little bit as soon as I get this guy opened. But let's go ahead and take a look at the box. As you can see, the front is an image of Jason's hockey mask. It says Freddy vs. Jason. On the side, it's another image of Jason. And it says NECA Real Toys. The other side is the same thing. There's the top. There's the bottom. This was gotten at GameStop for $26.99. And here's the back. There is a little read-up. And then pictures of the figure. And it says what he comes with. And a big thank you to all the people that were involved with this figure. And then we open it up. And there he is. And then there's the image right there. So, very cool, this figure right there. You can see him with all the accessories, kind of, sorry for the glare. But what I'm going to do is take a little bit and get this guy opened up. Okay, and we are back with Mr. Voorhees out of the box, and I actually am really liking this figure so far. But before we get into the figure, I always like to show the backdrop. And this backdrop is just woods. As you can see, I'm trying to get it where it's not glaring, but you can see the woods in there. And yeah, so there's the backdrop. And let's get into this figure and his articulation. This figure is huge, and he's so big that I had to put him farther on the table. So, we're just going to bring him in, and we're going to look at his articulation. So, he has a rotating neck. My figure is a little stiff. That's a good thing, though. He has ball hinge shoulders, ball hinge elbows, hinge wrists, jointed torso, hinged hips, hinged knees, and hinged ankles. So, like I said, mine are a little stiff, but that's a good thing. Not loose or anything. But let's go ahead and take a look at the details. Just look at his outfit. You can see the details right there on his shirt, and all the tears and rips on his jacket, his pocket right there. On the back, you can see more tears. I think that's supposed to be his skin. And then his pants also, and then just, this is also layered. And he has a soft undershirt on, and you can see he has another blue undershirt on as well. pants also have nice folds and wrinkles and tears in them. And he's wearing his big Frankenstein boots. Like, I like to call them Jason's disco boots. But they have nice detail on them too. Mainly just black. But this is a great figure and I'm really impressed so far. I think it's a very nice figure. Here is the hockey mask. Now this is the default hockey mask that you get. He's wearing in on the packaging. You do get two more, which we will take a look at in a moment when we look at accessories. But it's nice. It's kind of plain, but I do like it. You can kind of see his eyes in there. Probably not the one I'm going to have him displayed with, but it's so nice. And it is removable, and if we just remove, we'll take a look at the mask up close. It's a mask. And here's his face. Not a pretty face sculpt, he's kind of ugly. And now, in the movie, we only saw up to here. We never saw his full face. So yeah. Not my favorite face sculpt, but it's a good one. You can see he has some hair hanging down from there. And just lumps all over his head and, like that. So, yeah. So, a great figure, and he obviously has gloves on. Black gloves on. Which also have tears in them. And he does stand up, he does stand up good. So that's pretty much the figure. And I like that, it looks like he has another, shirt on underneath. Another jacket right there. I like that. So, the details are great on this figure. I really like them. I think they are really good. And unfortunately, this might be the last Jason Voorhees, figure from NECA just because of the legal issues. Yes, I'm very glad to have him. But let's get into accessories. So here are his accessories, and you get a fair amount. You get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 accessories. Just wanted to make sure. And let's go ahead and take a look. The first one we'll take a look at is the teddy bear. And I don't remember this in the movie. I think it was in a picture or something. A behind the scenes picture. But the teddy bear has nice details on it. You can see the sculpting work on it. And it looks like a real teddy bear. Doesn't have articulation or anything. Just sculpted. You can see some stuffing coming out. Right there. And it's cute. A little too cute for Jason, but you can take his hand and I'm gonna do this off camera. Should be right. And he can hold it like so. It's a little loose in his hands, but he can hold it like so. And he has this teddy bear. But there is the teddy bear. And it's cute. And then we do get two more masks. Now, this is the regular mask that came on. This is the clawed mask with Freddy's claw marks on it. Now, unfortunately, my mask came a little warped in the packaging. But hopefully, once we get this on Jason, it will look better. And I really like this mask. I like the weathering on it, and it looks nice. It doesn't look as plain as the regular mask. in my opinion. It looks weathered, more weathered and stuff. But let's go ahead and put it on Jason. And yeah, I like this. This might be the one I display Jason with. But he looks good. And the warping, it does help the warping as well. But he does look good with it. But let's go ahead and show the other mask. And that is the bloody mask. And this is when Freddy and Jason are all bloody at the end. And, you know, Jason gets his eyes gouged out. And unfortunately, this is a little warped as well. But let's go ahead and put it on Jason. I'm gonna go on. And there it is. Just, it was a little hard to, I think because it was warped. I also like this one too. Not sure which, I think go with the scratch faced one, but the bloody one is nice as well. Too many options. but it's pretty nice as well. But I like the scratch faced one, so I think we will keep the this one on him for now. So, yeah. Other accessories you do get are two machetes. You get one bloody one and one regular one. Oops, Jason almost fell. And we'll take a look at the regular one first. And it has some nice weathering to it. Not sure which one I'll be displaying him with. Maybe the bloody one, just because a lot of my Jasons already have regular machetes. The handle is nicely sculpted as well. And it looks nicely done. And it just can go in his hand like so. Want to be careful not to break it. There that is. So we'll go ahead and take it out. And here's the bloody machete with blood on it. It's also weathered and looks very nice. This also can go in his hand as well. Like so. And then the last accessory we get is a flame effect accessory. And this is the scene when he's in the cornfields killing all the people and gets gasoline on him and his machete lights on fire, and all you have to do is, I think it goes on this side, and yeah, and it's very cool effect, and it stays on too, it's not gonna fall off. Let's look at it on the bloody machete, which I think it probably would look a little better on the bloody machete, personally. There we are. Yeah, it looks a lot better on the bloody machete. I might actually display him with this, not sure yet, but the flame effects look good. They look cool. You got different shades of orange in there. And yeah. And that's all the accessories that Mr. Voorhees comes with this time. And here is Jason again. And we're gonna go ahead and get into the comparison of the old one with the new one. Okay, so here is the old Jason, NECA, Freddy versus Jason. Jason on the left, and then on the right is the new one. And before we get into the figures, I wanted to take a look at the machetes. This is the old machete, and unfortunately mine snapped, so I had to glue it back together. I don't think I did the best job, but hey, it's okay. But you can see the differences between there. I think the old one is a little bigger, and you can see it's more has a black wash on it, and then it has a little silver tip. But you can see the differences right there. But there they are. And this is the new one, this is the old one. And we're just gonna put the old one to the side along with the new one. And we'll bring in the old one and new one. And you can just see, they look similar, but you can just see they are different. They, obviously the new one has more articulation and the old one is very limited. Doesn't even have elbow articulation, just has a swivel in one elbow. This elbow, the other one is just permanently like that, just up for the machete. And I've always liked this figure, never had a problem with this figure, but since the new one came out, I think the new one is much better. Now, I put the original mask back on the new one just for review purposes, but I do like the clawed mask better. But you can, let's just take a look at, we'll take the mask off. And here are the masks. I think when it comes to comparing these two masks, I like the old one a little better because it's a little bit more weathered. The new one looks like just a generic hockey mask that Jason wears. You really could use it on any of your figures if you really wanted to. But there they are. So we're just going to set the mask down, and we'll bring in the face sculpts right there. And they are very similar looking, as you can see. This one's a little bit more lighter. And they both have the hair, although this one is a little bit more rubbery piece on it. Very similar looking, just one's a little bit lighter, one's a little bit darker. In the movie, it almost looks like he has black skin, but not on the figures, which is good, I like that. And then we get to the jackets and the shirts, and you can see the differences there. Again, similar, but different as well. And the pants, are different as well, because the old one is in a pre-pose. And then the shoes look similar as well, but they're actually sculpted different. Sorry if you heard that, the dog just got neutered yesterday, so he has a cone on his head, so he's making a lot of noise. But yeah, so there's differences there, then there's a difference on the sleeves, and then the gloves. I do like how on the old one you can see the skin. They did put that on the new one, but they didn't paint the skin. But yeah, there's differences between those two. Also like that they did paint a little silver on the old one. They didn't do that with the new one, but overall, I think the new one is a better figure anyway. Then they're both big figures, and they're both about the same size. I think Jason, Freddy versus Jason, Jason is the biggest Jason that we've seen. But there are the two Freddy versus Jason NECA figures. And I just wanted to bring in the remake 2009 Ultimate Jason, and I thought this guy was big, but obviously not compared to the Freddy versus Jason Jason figure. And you can just see he looks much smaller compared to the Freddy versus Jason version. And but I like them both. I think I like the Freddy versus Jason figure a little bit better, but I just wanted to show these guys for a size comparison. You can see right there. And the remake Jason was pretty large for his movie, but compared to the Freddy versus Jason, Jason Voorhees, not really. but there are those two right there. So here are all my Jason figures from the Ultimate line. Technically, Part 3 is not the Ultimate version. I got that figure before it was repacked onto the Ultimate version, but it is the same sculpt, so I did add it in this video. But you can see all of them looking. We have Part 2, Part 3, Part 4, Part 5, the Dream Sequence Jason, the remake, and then Freddy vs. Jason, the Jason we are taking a look at today. The only one I'm missing here is Part 6. I saw it a couple of times in stores, just passed up on it for other figures, but I do want to add that one to my collection as well. I love all these. My favorite one probably has to be the Freddy vs. Jason one, although I really do like the Part 4 one here. And the remake one is nice too. They're all really nice figures, actually. My least favorite probably is the Dream Seekers one, just because you can't take off any of the mask, and yeah, and it's pretty much the same figure as the Part 4 Jason, just a little glossier. But let me know which one is your favorite NECA Jason. Is it the Part 2, Part 3, Part 4, Part 5 remake, or Freddy vs. Jason? Really glad to have all these in my collection. But let's get into final thoughts. So, all in all, I really do like this figure. It's probably one of my favorite Ultimate Jason figures that I own so far. And it's really sad to know that this might be the last Ultimate Jason for a while, just because of legal rights. I do believe we are still getting the Part 5 Roy Jason figure, which I obviously will be getting. And then the Lady of the Lake, Pamela Voorhees, which obviously is a must-have for me because she's my favorite. I even like her better than Jason. But this figure is a must-have for any Jason fan. The accessories are nice, the figure is nice, and just the detail on the figure is nice overall. Really like the flame effect. I think that's how I'll be displaying my figure this way. That's how I probably will. So let me know your thoughts down below on which is your favorite Jason and what you think of this Jason. And until the next video, please subscribe to my channel. And all my information is down below. Go ahead and check out my Instagram. That's where I post my pictures, and that's the account I'm most active on. And until the next video, I will see you guys later. Okay, bye.